What's up, guys? We finally got all of the new slime units. Yes, sir. And guess what? We got a couple of them with glitched as well. So today we're going to be doing the best slime units versus infinite mode. And we're going to be checking out each and every unit and seeing what they are good for. So we have Overlord are better on all of them. Let's get it popping. And of course, we got Yojin as well. So we're going to hop on into the hardest infinite mode and we're going to see how hard we can pop off, guys. So it looks like Shibuya is the current leaderboard. I don't know, man. We'll see if we can get to maybe 158, but on a we'll see what Abandoned Cathedral is. All right. So actually, you know what? Yeah, we'll do Abandoned Cathedral. So let's get it popping and let's go see how far we can make it. And remember, guys, at 1 million subscribers, we are doing the 1 million Robux giveaway. All you guys have to do to enter is hit subscribe. And yeah, we'll get it popping. So make sure you guys subscribe and like if you want to enter in that 1 million Robux giveaway. So here we go. Let's get it started. So first up, you're going to notice that there is really no, what I would say, starter unit here. So all of them have a decently high placement cost. However, I will say the best starter unit is definitely Oni General. All right, I have Overlord on him, and he's 1,000 damage. However, I mean, 1,000 cost. However, he does have Black Flames as his passive. So while his damage looks weak, overall it adds up quite a bit. So it looks like they're starting off with 30k because of how high up this infinite mode is, but we'll get him down at the start. Remember, he is a fire passive, so that's not ideal, but he's going to be doing quite a bit of damage here. So it looks like he is doing 142,000 with 685 off the Black Flames. Now, Black Flames last a while, so it will probably take a while to kill the enemy, but overall it is pretty good. So let's also farm as well. Now, none of these units are very expensive to max, so we should have no problems there. But I do want to eventually move up a little bit because I want to, you know, get this guy in the front so he can start clapping. So I'm going to go just quickly place Rimuru in the back real quick and we'll turn on effects so you guys can see them. And I'll let Rimuru cook in the back and we'll check out this guy's effect and upgrades. So here we go. Let's do that real quick after I go max out my farms. All right, here we go. Let's go. Oh, so he's currently not even able to handle off wave 18. Dang, we got our farms maxed out. So let's go upgrade him a bit. So first upgrade 300k, a little bit weak. Then we got 2 million. All right, so he's doing a lot of damage total. It just takes a little while. So I'm gonna leave him on last here and we'll let him torch these guys. So wow, 5 million damage, not bad. Okay, now he's circle AoE. All right, and he is hybrid as well now too, which is great. 4 million damage, 24 million over time, which is crazy. And then hell cannon, look at that, guys. 24 million, 32 over time with Overlord. All right, so let's get that popping off. And then, all right, looks like he stays with this AoE. So it looks like his AoE is a little bit small. Now, remember, we don't have any godlies in the front because there is no godly this update. Rimuru is the closest thing we have to a godly this update. So 9 million damage, and we got 45 million after Black Flames. Not bad at all. Now, the thing is, he is a fire element unit. And these guys are water, so it's not the greatest combo, but it is what it is. All right, let's move on to our stun unit. All right, she starts off with stun. You can kind of see stun's effects. And honestly, look at her attack effects, guys. They're insane. So here we go. Let's get her a couple upgrades. Looks like she's still circle, and she's only ground. However, she is doing a decent amount of damage. And so with Draco Burst, she's now doing even a bigger AoE. 4 SPA, so pretty good. Not really any skill tree on her, so it'll get faster than that. So she'll be even better. And then we've got Draco Nova, so an even slightly bigger AoE. However, you're going to notice the cooldown did go up a bit. All right, and she has some pretty good damage. So take a look at that, guys. 18.4 million damage at max and stun. So not a bad unit. I believe maybe the highest damaging stun in the game. Now, if we take a look at the damage DPS boards. All right, so here we go. We have Milim at number 9 with her AoE circle, which is very good, guys. It's top 10 DPS right there and stun. Dang, 13.64 mil. And Oni General is at number 7 with his Black Flame. All right, now they don't have full AoEs. So they're not high on the AoE DPS boards, but look at that, guys. That's actually insane. So you can definitely tell she has some crazy DPS. All right, next up we got Lord Noir. He is a great unit because he starts off as a hybrid, unlike most of the units on this list. So that is very nice. Okay, I'm gonna go upgrade my unit in the back so we don't die. We are on wave 41, so we are getting up there. They're already at 5 million HP, jeez. All right, that's insane. All right, so here we go. Lord Noir, Damon. All right, 600k, so really low starting damage. Now, he is max level, guys. I don't know why it's starting off so low. And he is Overlord, so that's a little bit sad. So, oh, here we go. So, zero cannon. This is when his damage jumps up. So, you're going to see he jumps up all the way to 20 million. However, his SP also doubles as well. So, it's not as good as you think. But look at the AoE. It's a lot better, so I'll take it. And then 25k and then 40k. So, 32 million damage with a 9 SPA. Not bad at all. And, in fact, that puts him decently high on this list. So, Diablo is at number 13. On this list. All right, not bad at all. A little bit lower, but I will say his AoE is quite a bit better, so that's why he's a little bit lower on this list. All right, next up we have one of my favorite units of this update. We have a Voldera. Look at that guy, starting damage 4 million, which makes sense because he starts off with a 10k cost, but look at that damage, guys, insane. Then Lightning Eruption, now he has a really nice AoE. And it gets even better, guys. Look how insane this guy's damage is getting. 16 million? Dude, what? 31 million? 38 million? And he has a pretty decently fast SPA, too. Now, I do have glitched on him, so that's probably affecting it a little bit. But look at that, guys. Full AoE, decent range, and look at that damage, guys. 60 million damage over 5 seconds is OP. In fact, that puts him all the way up, guys, at number 6. Highest DPS in the game, which is absolutely awesome. Now, there is one unit higher than our boy Voldera, and that is Rimuru. So, Rimuru, I'm going to place right here so she hits the whole map. All right, here we go. She is absolutely insane. So, she's not quite air yet, but she is water, which isn't the greatest. But we actually have no grass units, which is funny because the portal needs grass units. So Flame Pillar makes her a flame, and I did actually give her the Soul of Brute Force, 15% damage, which is really good. However, the burn one, oh wait, I think I had the wrong burn one. I don't think burn works on Black Flames, but maybe it does. All right, and she has some pretty crazy damage. Look at that. And then she does become AoE. Look at that AoE, guys, with Gluttony. Really, really good AoE. And then Wrath of Gods, guys, she becomes a full AoE absolute beast. All right, in fact, on the list, number 5 highest DPS in the game, and number 1 better than Escanor if you factor in AoE, which is absolutely insane. And of course, fear as well as the status effect and a nuke. Absolutely busted. So let's get our team set up so we're ready to cook. And I will turn off the effect. So we're currently on wave 62, not bad at all. And all right, first up, we're going to get Dragon Princess down. Now, Dragon Princess is our stun unit. So we're just going to leave her like so. And also one of our top DPSs. I'm just going to put her on strongest so she takes care of business. All right, next up we have Oni General. He's our Black Flames unit. He is a line AoE, so I'm going to leave him on last. So he's going to hit quite a bit. And then Voldera is our a Lightning unit. So we're going to use Voldera in a decent spot and use his full AoE to really get things popping off. So here we go. All right, I'm going to have it so where's this? All the way up to here. So I'm going to smooth Milim a little bit. So Milim's going to stun him at the start. And then after the stun happens, we're going to have Veldora lightning them all within Rimuru's range, which is going to be busted OP. And then we got another just straight up damage unit. I'm going to put this damage unit here just for like mainly the bosses that get through. He's going to be able to hammer those with his nice range. I believe that is everybody placed. So this should get us pretty good. So we're on wave 70 right now with no real issues. 75 billion, and of course we got quite a bit of kills as well. Here we go. So not bad at all. So we're gonna go skip ahead now and get it cracking. But it looks like they have 500 million HP, which is insane. And it looks like the mini boss also got Shrek too, which is great. All right, so the mini boss is doing the disappearing thing. And look at how much HP that mini boss has. So I think it's time for Rimuru Nuke Armageddon. There we go. Should completely wipe the entire map. There we go. Look at that damage, guys. Just skyrocketed. Love to see it. Unfortunately, we're going to have to wait for that to recharge. And it looks like it didn't even kill this guy. Oh my gosh. What the heck? This guy has 12 billion HP on wave 83. Okay, he might be the death of us. Yeah, it looks like this map is pretty small. So I'm a little bit sad on that part. So I don't think we'll be able to touch this boss. Yeah, we haven't even done that much damage to him. Dang. All right, well, that's a little bit unfortunate. But honestly, wave 86 ain't bad for a solo run. But considering we don't have all glitch units, this is actually pretty impressive. So I would say my favorite unit is definitely Rimuru. Rimuru's the go-to, but my Veldora is also ridiculous. I love lightning. And Oni General is also a pretty decent unit too. So these two are definitely my favorite in this update. So highly, highly recommend it. I think Lord Nord might be my least favorite just because, you know, he has no status effect. And honestly, stun isn't that great either. So there you go, guys. Wave 89. All right. Let me know if you guys want me to do any other challenges, and I'll catch you guys in the next one. Peace out.